Well, shit, no, nothing's happened, Jack. Don't you save something? I always like to pretend there's somebody with me who agrees with me who's invisible. I do that in arguments. When I'm arguing with someone and they're arguing and I turn and I look at my invisible friend, I'm like... And my invisible friend's like, I know, they're a jerk. I've been married 3 times. So here's some news. I got my new glasses today. I wear glasses, but I don't wear them. I don't wear them on TV. Well, not that this really counts as TV. I don't wear it on public access vision. But I got new glasses today, and they look quite good. They're like Mad Men glasses. Not Mad Men, the highly acclaimed TV series. Mad Men, just like mad guys wearing glasses. Like eyes that go boggly out. No, I got new glasses, and I'm debating whether I should wear my glasses on the show. And then I thought, well, I'll do what I always do, which is I'll come to you, the viewer, Mrs. Henderson, and... And I'll say, send me your emails and your tweets to the show, and we'll have a competition to whether or not I should wear my glasses on the show. And the winner gets a trip to Australia with Oprah. And also, I'll pretend that I give a f- what you think. And then... I'm kidding. No, I do wear glasses in my life, but I sometimes, if I wear them on TV, will I be less of a sex object? You know, people say, when you hear actors and actresses saying, I want to be taken seriously, I'm not just a sex object, I'm like, I'll take sex object. Anyway, I think that's pretty serious, isn't it? To be taken as a sex... I like that. I very rarely laugh when I'm thinking sexy thoughts. It's true, though, isn't it? So, anyway, send me your emails and your coupons. Yeah, send me coupons, because CBS doesn't pay for... Ooh la la! And I really need some help at the supermarket. I need to get the skeleton some new back-to-school wear. Yeah, anyway, Kristen Bell's here tonight, so we'll be all right. I'll see you in a minute.
Late Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Progressive. Visit progressive.com today.
Thank you for your completely genuine applause. No, stop, you must. No, whoa, boy. Oh. It's gonna be a long night. I'm sorry you can't sleep, but think how much worse it could be. could be here. I'm kidding, of course. Am I? Yes, I am, actually. And I'll tell you why. Because it's a great day for America, everybody. It is. That is a great day for America, but it is a bad day for the singer George Michael. You know George Michael with a careless whisper and the guilty feet of God, no rhythm, lady, did, and in the bathroom with the policeman.
It wasn't his feet that were guilty.
Anyway, he's going. He's going to jail, George Michael. He's going to jail because he crashed his car under the influence of,
drugs.
The judge gave him 8 weeks in jail. George says he'll appeal for a longer sentence. Health experts are saying that hand washing in public restrooms is actually on the rise, which is good to know. But I think that's just what health experts say after they're arrested for loitering in public restrooms. I was counting people who washed their hands. Imagine if that was your job. Where can I send my resume? Do what you love, you'll never work a day in your life.
You got that right,
exactly. Anyway, it's a big day in politics, of course. The primary elections in 7 states, people are going to the polls, are casting their vote, and everyone's talking about the same thing. Yes, this! Scientists have found that bats have regional accents. Yes! Never mind the polls, who gives a rat's ass about that? Pasha! Bats have accents. I've always wondered. Yeah. Because today, Australian scientists announced they finally solved the age-old question, do bats have accents? And the answer is yes, they do, of course. You know bats, they're hideous things with scary teeth, huge ears. Is there a picture of a bat? There's one. So, I'm kidding. That's... Of course, His Royal Highness Prince Great Big Charles of... there he is. That's Prince Charles, that's not a bat. My apologies to bats. Bats are like, what happened? What did he do? Bats are small mammals. Basically, they're just big-eared flying squirrels, but they're not as cute as squirrels, and they don't hide their nuts for the winter. I hide my nuts for the winter in woolly Speedos. By the way, woolly Speedos is a new NASCAR driver. It's a hell of a year, though, for Australian scientists. Last week, they discovered tractor beams. Remember, we talked about that last week? And then now they found out bats have accents. Is there anything Australian scientists can't do? Right now, we're trying to train dingoes to protect babies. It's not going that well right now. Anyway, all this stuff about animals with accents, nothing new. I grew up in a different country. What? Yes. And on British television in the 1970s, they had a show called Animal Magic. And they take a video footage of animals and they put in voices with accents. It was like, you know, when Bob Saget did the funniest video thing, but it was with animals, you know. Yeah, you think this show is crap? You should have seen Animal Magic. It was like, at least there's the skeleton, I suppose. Anyway, when you see a nature documentary footage of animals, by the way, that sound isn't real. It's added on later. You know when you always see the sound, the animals eating a bug or something and you can hear the... That's not real. They're not close enough to get... That's not the noise it makes anyway. They don't have glands like that. So it's just a guy in a studio going... And that's just... Like that. It's the same with porn. That sound isn't real. It's just a guy in a studio going...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's right.
Mm-hmm.
The guy's slapping his own ass and everything. It's not really what I'm talking about. No, bats with accents. Anyway, the side the Australian scientists have said the most talkative bats were in Central Australia, the loudest bats were in Northern Australia, and the quietest bats were in the Dodgers lineup. Jeff, for that sporty meow.
Will this affect my job review?
Nah, you'll be all right. As long as you don't do that in my pants thing again.
Bony high five.
Yeah, okay. By the way, bony high fives, never mind. I want to talk about bats. I'm very excited about this bat thing. Now, bats don't really speak, of course. They make a high-pitched sound, a kind of sound like that. Kind of like, they're like Justin Bieber with fur. And the scientists... I'm trying to explain science to you bastards! The scientists have found that bats who live in the forest make different sounds from bats who live in caves or bats who live in rich neighborhoods are like, I say, Muffy, you've got a lovely set of wings. And bats who live in tough neighborhoods are like, oh, yeah, can I hide your nuts? French bats can just kind of shrug their wings. Bats like living in dark caves. I'm surprised we don't have any in the studio, actually, when I think about it. I was implying that the studio is a dark cave. But if you have to explain the joke, it's not really a joke. It's just a sentence. We'll press on with the bat stuff. I'm committed to the bat. You know, if you find a bat in your house, they say you should leave all the windows and doors open until it leaves. It's the same thing I do with Regis. But it doesn't work. It doesn't work. He stays. But it gets that Regis-y smell out.
Break time?
Yes, actually, it is break time. Are you working in cahoots with him now?
Yep. 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 I gave that up, Craig. Yep.
Oh, shut up. This thing is so stupid. No, stop it. All right, we're going to take a commercial break, which is great news because the commercials tonight are really good. We'll be right back. You're here. We just during the commercial break, this camera stopped working, and I was going to, but Mark, who works this camera, he was going like that, like pretending it was working, but it wasn't working, and so I was trying to sneak into this camera here, but then I came back. Craig, that's the most exciting thing we've ever seen on TV. Yeah, take that, house. My first guest tonight is a very talented actress. One of my favorite guests on the show. She's maybe my favorite guest. Yeah, my favorite guest. Except if you could make it. She's very lovely, though. She's in a movie called You Again, which is in theaters in September the 24th. Take a look at this.
Grandma, is there anything I can help you with?
Oh, here, dear. They were a little loose. We can't have them falling out on the dance floor.
I don't think
they're just dentures. Get over it. Now, and be sure and press hard, dear. We need a tight seal. I might be kissing later.
Oh. There we go. Okay.
That's what it's like at my house every day. Please welcome the adorable Kristen Bell, everybody. Kristen Bell.
Hello.
you look nice.
I found these in the green room.
Oh, you shouldn't put them in your mouth.
It smells like grapes. Smell it.
No.
Doesn't it?
That's not grapes. I know grapes. I love grapes, but that's not grapes.
Do you think it's candy or what?
No, I think it's ass.
It's not ass.
It is. Clean.
Maybe
clean.
It is
clean.
Ass.
Yeah, it is.
Taste it.
No.
No, taste it because I think
no.
It's.
No.
I want to know if it's candy or wax. Taste it. Just taste it. No, taste it like that. Taste like, take a little bit of it. And try it.
It's if you can break it like that, it's candy, isn't it?
Is it?
No! No! What the hell are you doing? You're just picking up random objects and then eating them?
It's grape wax.
Grape wax?
That's what it is.
What are you doing to... Oh, see, I...
Craig, I was bored. They were in
clearly.
The green room.
Look at this. No, look, here's some of that. Hang on.
And my mic is falling off. I'm
yeah, your microphone fell off. What the hell? Do you want me to fix it?
No, it's all right. Nah, whatever. Who cares?
Yeah, you've got a very nice spine. I've never noticed your spine.
It's a pretty decent average spine.
No, you're selling yourself short.
Well,
let me have a look at that.
Thank you very much.
Whoa, look at that puppy right there. I bet you've got a really awesome skeleton in there.
Speaking of my arch nemesis.
He's not your arch nemesis.
Isn't he? Isn't he, though?
No.
Nice podium, Jeff. Because I wanted to be your co-host. I explained this to you last time.
Right.
And he put in his application at the same time I did. And, you know, he got the job, and that's fine. And then you demoted him because now he's no longer sitting next to the guest because he's what? He's creepy.
No. It's not because he's creepy.
Isn't it?
No, it's because there he's nearer an outlet. Yeah, give him a snake mug, yeah. Well, you know why? Casting couch.
What?
Oh, yeah.
That up, Craig.
Yeah, it was out there. Kristen, I want to be taken seriously. Jeff, I want to be a sex object. Who do you think gets the job?
Well played, Craig.
Why did you pick up a wax moustache and just start eating it? Do you feel like... Just like go around the house eating stuff. Like, oh, I wonder what that is.
No. If I'm hungry, it was in a package.
You just.
It was packaged, meaning it was safe.
That doesn't mean it's safe. Yes. It just means it's been packaged.
No, because I opened it.
Well, that doesn't. Well, you think that doesn't mean anything? There could have been explosives in there.
I don't know, Craig. Did it explode?
Not yet.
Then it was safe. Not yet.
Do you like bats?
Yeah.
Do you like bats that have got accents?
Of course. Those are the best kind of bats.
I've never noticed bats having accents. Whenever I've seen a bat, they're just like...
How often do you see bats?
Often.
Often?
Yes, I'm a vampire. Would you go to Transylvania if I said...
I've been to Transylvania.
No way.
Yes, we.
No way.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you go to Dracula's castle?
I did.
Did you see Dracula?
I did not. Because he is a fictional character.
Well, yes. But so is Mickey Mouse, and he's at Disneyland all the time.
Truth. No, but I went. I shot a movie in Romania a long time ago, and it was almost kind of the castle was beautiful, but everyone outside was selling like really sort of cheap American like Transylvania shirts, and I just felt like we're making a mockery of this.
Yes, making a mockery of an otherwise beautiful story of a blood-sucking count from the depths of hell. Are you into all that? You into all the Twilight and the other? What's the other one? True Blood, is that what
it's called? I've seen one episode of True Blood, but
right.
It was a very naked episode,
it's
and
porn.
I was a little scared.
I'm sorry, my wife watches it. You know my wife.
I
You're
do.
Friendly with it.
Very.
She watches that. So I'm like,
your wife is a perv.
I know. She's like, oh, I like the big Danish Viking vampire, and I'm like, this is porn.
Oh my God.
People are making that, and they're going. That, they do that. That was my first job when I came to Hollywood.
Porn?
Yeah.
No, it wasn't.
I got offered a porn.
You did?
Yeah.
Did you do it?
No.
Why did randomly get offered a porn?
Well, I didn't say I randomly got offered a porn. Well, I knew a guy who knew a guy who, and I was out of work, and he said, I'll give you a job in one of my movies. And then I got the script.
Step into my basement.
They had a script, and it was like for an hour long movie, right? Or hour and a half long movie. And the script was like 4 pages. I'm like, oh, there's probably a lot of improvisation. And there was. I wish I'd done it though now.
Really?
Yeah, because now I can't regret it.
You can't regret it?
I think my kids would like it when they get older, see what their dad looked like.
I don't think your wife would like it, although since she loves True Blood, maybe
right,
she
Right, that's
would.
What I'm saying. She watches True Blood, and, you know, if I'd say, well, honey, I made a porn, look at this. No vampires in it, though.
Yeah.
Betty White's in your film.
Truth.
That's good.
Who do you like?
Why are you saying truth? Is that a new thing that the kids are doing?
No.
You've done it twice now.
I don't know.
No, you're doing it. You're trying to make it happen, aren't you? It's like truth.
Truth, yeah, like leg warmers when I tried to bring those back. That didn't work.
You forgot to wear them. You were too busy.
No, I didn't. But in college,
awesome
I tried
shoes,
to bring. Thank you very much.
Awesome. Let me see. Yeah.
Thanks.
Good. You got toe cleavage there as well.
I do.
Which is, yeah,
I do.
That's always good.
Yeah.
Little bit of toe. It implies 5 little boobies. By the way, 5 little boobies is the name of a cartoon.
And it was the name of that movie you were offered a long time ago.
Yeah, 5 little boobies. No,
mm-hmm.
It wasn't.
No.
The only thing I was at least relieved to see is there were ladies in the porn that I was offered.
Thank God.
I had no scenes with them.
Who do you like better, me or Betty White?
I like you in different ways. Well, I like you both the same, except, to be honest, Betty and I kind of go back a little further. Like, Betty was the first person I met when I came to America. She was in that porn.
Fair enough.
So I have a kind of special affection for her.
I have a special affection for her, too.
Yeah,
she's lovely.
I love Betty.
She's the greatest.
Yeah. She doesn't wear dentures, though, as I recall. That must have been some kind of CGI thing.
Yeah, that was fake.
Yeah, fake.
It wasn't CGI. It was just they put in gums, and then when I went like that, they were her real teeth.
All right. Did you have a wax mustache in this movie? Did you wear a mustache?
I wish. No, I didn't. But I did wear braces and glasses, and I had pimples all over my face.
Really?
Yes.
Do you play the young version of you who's What's the story of the movie?
The story is basically a girl who had a really rough time in high school and was tormented by one girl in particular. And then, you know, she grows up, sheds her skin, moves
sheds
away from
her skin?
Home. No, but blossoms, you know?
Oh, I thought you were like...
No.
Because I was like, I'm in, let's go!
It's a horror movie.
Yeah.
Blossoms and comes back to find out that her brother is engaged to the girl that made her life miserable.
Oh, shut up!
I swear. So it's basically about me trying to ruin the wedding. But I got to play my high school self, and I got to wear glasses and these amazing braces that I wore to the rap party. And I had like really kind of greasy hair, and you know that thing, girls, like where you said you had bangs, but you really had wispies? You had like, these were your bangs. It was gross. You wouldn't understand, Craig.
I've got that now.
But they put pimples all over my face, and I really wanted to go further with it, and I stepped out of the trailer with like 35 whiteheads all over my face. And the producers were like, no, I don't
know. Too much?
Too much, yeah. So they had me reel it in.
I had terrible acne when I was young.
You did?
I did, yeah.
I'm so sorry.
It was very bad. Well, we thought at the time, it was during the Middle Ages, we thought at the time that rubbing butter on it would help. But it doesn't.
But it doesn't.
I actually, the worst acne I ever got, I went to a fancy dress party when I was a teenager as Dracula, but we didn't have any hair cream, so I did use butter on my hair.
And you got acne on your head?
Yes, because as I was dancing with hot Scottish girls from the 1970s, the butter started to run down my oily teenage skin, and I was like a dancing vampire omelet.
You must have smelled delicious.
I still do. We have to. I didn't do the emails tonight. Do you want to stay and do the emails?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. I feel a bit crowded by the cameras tonight. What's going on?
They're I need a lot of shots.
Yeah.
Why really is the right all kind of close up.
Do you give them special instructions when you come here?
No. I take their instructions. We have to take a break, but we'll be right back with Kristen Bell.
Awesome! We found another one of the mustaches that Kristen was so humorously wearing earlier, and they are edible.
But the first ingredient is refined wax.
Yeah, so it's edible wax, and it's made by the Wacko Wax Company. Funny enough, Wacko Wax was the name of that porn. Uh-oh, did we just get in trouble? Oh, okay, good. Do you want to ask Jeff Peterson to do the tweets and emails jingle?
Yeah.
All right.
Sure. Jeff. Would you please do the tweets and emails jingle?
Tweet mails and don't be stingy.
On you go then.
Duck and cover and don't look back. Here comes an email and Twitter attack. Giant freaky monsters crushing our city. It's a jumbo lizard wrecking committee. So grab your ray gun and your rocket back and join the email Twitter attack!
That is cool. You have to take him or it's going to be cold.
Oh, I know.
Oh, hi. Right, we've got the tweeters and the emails, all right? You ready? Okay, I'll take that as a yes.
I thought you were talking to them.
No, no.
Yeah, I'm ready. I was born ready.
All right, this is from Julian in Toronto, in Ontario, which is in Canada.
Mm-hmm.
Been up there?
Yep.
Okay. hey, Craig, and Kristen, he probably would have said it. As the driver of the car, shouldn't I be the one to choose what plays on the radio?
Negative. And I'll tell you, I actually do know the answer to this. The person who is in the passenger seat is the radio captain. Your eyes should be on the road, your hands should be at 10 and 2. So, Julian, I'm sorry, the radio captain is to your right.
All right. CBS in no way endorses the views of Kristen Bell. This is from Daniel in Lubbock, Texas. Says, dear Craig and Kristen, why do people say an elephant never forgets? I've never understood this. Kristen, do you know why?
I think because elephants have very, very good memories. I know that seems like a very common sense answer, but it's true. I mean...
They actually don't.
They don't?
No, no, no. It's actually... I saw this on Mythbusters.
They're the smartest ones next to us. They mourn their dead. They get drunk.
Yeah, these are all smart things to do.
The most emotionally
I can't believe he's dead. I saw it in Mythbusters. Because it's a myth that an elephant never forgets. What happens is they got this elephant and they blew it up. I'm joking, they didn't blow up an elephant. Oh, Lord. By the way, blowing up an elephant was the name of the... Never mind. You read it out there.
We got this one from Beth. From Decatur, Georgia. Hi, Craig and Kristen.
Yeah, right.
Will you be coming to Atlanta to see the Salvador Dali exhibit at the High Museum this fall?
Oh. Well, will you? Kristen, what are you doing this fall?
I'm going to Alaska.
Really?
Yes, to shoot a movie, and I'm...
Is it one of those movies where you have to stay awake and solve the murderer before the end of the
Unfortunately,
summer?
No. It's okay. A movie about a whale rescue.
Oh, that's great! Did the whales... You know, whales never forget the aquatic version of elephants.
Fair enough.
Whales do not forget. And they mourn their dead and get drunk. Do you know they used the idea of the elephant's graveyard? This is true. That the elephants bury their dead.
I know, I told you that. I did.
I know.
All right, let's see what we got here. All right, here's
Sheila. Wouldn't wanna be. Sheila from Larkspur, California. Dear Craig and Kristen, I can't decide whether to accept a scholarship to auto mechanic school or continue to study ballet. Oh, I see now. I'm sorry, I wrote that off. I said, listen, if it's free, it's for me. That's what I say. Or continue to study ballet. Well, Sheila, are you a man or a woman?
Hey, whoa, slow down there, Grandma. You can study ballet and be a man or mechanic business?
Absolutely, it's just not the norm. And I was simply saying she might fit into one profession more. She, he, she. Whoever she may be.
Yeah, well, I think that, Sheila is usually an indication of femininity.
Femininity. Sheila, you gotta follow your heart.
I've seen this movie, though. Auto mechanic, ballet school. Did you remember Billy Elliot, that movie?
Yeah.
But it was
a it was like 5 years ago.
I never forget movies. I'm like an elephant. Do you know that elephants remember movies? Like, if you show a movie to an elephant and then come back later and go, did you like that movie? It'll go, uh-huh.
What? So, Sheila, we don't know, because we don't know.
Well, I know, but I'm not going to tell you. Follow your dreams. CBS doesn't endorse you following your dreams. I think you can be an auto mechanic ballet dancer. In fact, I think that would be a good show on CBS this fall.
I think we got some. Sheila, we're going to need you to come backstage after the show. Actually, I think, Sheila, that you could take the scholarship, because scholarships are great, and then continue to study ballet maybe on the weekends and do what you love and also have a steady job. Right?
Wait.
Yeah.
Do not applaud that kind of thing. It's very daytime television what just happened there. You know, you gave
super supportive to Sheila, who
Yeah. Sheila, the transsexual ballet dancing mechanic. And you judged her and said she should have her dream at the weekend and work during the week. Hell, have your dream all the time and
tootsie frootsie
your work.
That's terrible. I feel bad now.
I like
your nail. We're out of time. We can't do it anymore.
Okay.
I like your nail polish, though. I was going to say that.
Thanks.
It looks quite chocolatey.
Do you want to borrow my wardrobe?
Yeah. Well, you're going to be in Alaska, so.
You can have a crack at my closet. You and Sheila.
We can wear our little waxy mustaches. Yeah. Well, we're done here. That's
okay.
It. Yeah. So you're going to Alaska then?
Yep.
All right. So when will you be back?
Thanksgiving. A little after Thanksgiving.
Oh, you want to come back then?
Yeah.
All right.
I'll come back.
Not for Thanksgiving, because we're already booked up. I'm kidding.
Oh,
I'm kidding. We don't do a show on Thanksgiving.
Do you do a show before Thanksgiving?
No.
You don't do any shows before Thanksgiving?
No, a month either side of Thanksgiving.
Because that's your favorite holiday, Thanksgiving?
That's the one. That and Shark Week. Oh, you're done now? You would like some commercials, so you thought you'd give a little applause? Is that the idea?
We're really over now.
Okay.
We're in trouble.
Kristen Bell, everybody! We'll be right
That's creepy, right?
No, but they do.
You do.
Grammy Award-winning artist here to perform Forgiveness from her new album, Laws of Illusion. Please welcome back to the show, Sarah McLachlan.
Love and lying enemy, I have seen your face before. Never thought again I'd see, didn't want to anymore.
If you're watching Craig at home, you're missing half the fun. Consider this your formal invitation to laugh live in our studio audience at a taping of The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson. Please give us a call at 323-570-0059 or visit our website at oneiota.com.